CO2 therapy, what, why, and how? What is CO2 therapy? So when we inhale, we take in oxygen. And in our body, carbon dioxide is produced. And the excess is exhaled. So CO2 therapy, it is about optimizing the levels of carbon dioxide in your body, which for most people means increasing the levels, increasing the tolerance for carbon dioxide. Why CO2 therapy? What are the benefits? Well, popular belief is that carbon dioxide is just a simple waste product that we should get rid of as soon as possible. But this is not correct. It turns out that carbon dioxide is crucial for oxygenating our body. So let's look at the 5 steps of oxygenation where carbon dioxide is heavily involved. The first step, that's the inhale. We take in oxygen from the atmosphere, and we may think that it is lack of oxygen in our body that makes us take the next breath, but that is not true. It is the buildup of excess carbon dioxide that stimulates our breathing center in our brainstem. In the brainstem, we have survival functions like temperature, heart rate, and breathing. And there are chemoreceptors, and they are stimulating when the levels of carbon dioxide increase in your body to a certain level. And then they send a signal to the diaphragm, which moves down, and we take in oxygen. So that's the first step, where carbon dioxide makes us take the next breath, makes us take in oxygen. Second step is that carbon dioxide makes the smooth muscle that surrounds our airways. Carbon dioxide makes them relax and widen, so the airways are kept open so that the air can flow easily, the oxygen can flow easily from the atmosphere down into the lungs. Third step is to keep the blood vessels open so that the blood can flow easily. And the same goes here. Carbon dioxide has this relaxing, widening effect on the smooth muscles that also surround the blood vessels. The fourth step is that offloading oxygen, when it reaches the cells where there is a need for oxygen, obviously we want oxygen to leave the blood that normally sits tight, bound to hemoglobin. And here, carbon dioxide is important to make the hemoglobin release the oxygen. It is called the Bohr effect. So when the oxygen leaves the blood, it can go into the mitochondria of the cell and be of use. And then the fifth step of the oxygenation is to use the oxygen to produce energy. And the mitochondria, that is where most of our energy is produced. They are called the powerhouses of our cells. And oxygen is kind of both a curse and a blessing. We can't live without it. It's super important for us to be able to produce energy efficiently. So if we produce energy without oxygen, we can only extract a little energy from the food we eat, up to only about 6%. While when oxygen is available, up to 100% of the available energy can be extracted. That's why we are so dependent on oxygen, to produce energy efficiently. And this is done in the mitochondria. And the thing with oxygen is that it is extremely reactive. So if there is not a control system, a safeguard system in the mitochondria, this process will go out of hand and the mitochondria will start to leak free oxygen radicals or free radicals. And this gives rise to oxidative stress and inflammations. So a number of studies have shown that carbon dioxide has antioxidant capabilities. So that means that the carbon dioxide is there to make sure that the mitochondria are not damaged. So as we can see in all these 5 steps, taking the oxygen from the atmosphere all the way to the mitochondria and produce energy, carbon dioxide is crucial. carbon dioxide paves the way for efficient oxygenation. How do you do CO2 therapy? There are many different ways to do CO2 therapy. The simplest way is just to slow down your breathing by closing your mouth and take a little longer exhale than the inhale. This will ensure that you keep more CO2 in your body. When you reduce your breathing, slow down your breathing, you will exhale less CO2. So that is CO2 therapy in its simplest form. Anyone can do that. What you also can do is that you can inhale extra CO2. And one way to do that is to just do, put your hands over your mouth and the nose. And some of the carbon dioxide that you just exhaled then will be trapped in the hands, and you will inhale extra CO2, because we exhale about 100 times more carbon dioxide than we normally inhale. You can also do bag breathing, put a bag in front of your face, or masks that were popular during the pandemic. That's another form of inhaling extra CO2, because the mask will trap some of the CO2 in the exhale air. Or you can use a device like our CO2 inhaler, where you inhale a little extra CO2 from a gas tank, for example, a SodaStream cylinder. You can also inject CO2. It's popular in treating scars and cellulites. You can immerse your body in CO2. It's popular to do foot baths, hand baths, face baths, or immerse your whole body, for example, using our CO2 suit. And it's easy to do these foot baths and face baths and hand baths yourself. You just take one part sodium bicarbonate, or it's also called baking soda, and one part of citric acid or ascorbic acid, and you mix it in the water and you immerse your feet, your hands, or your face. You can also insufflate CO2 rectally or vaginally. And it was popular around the end of the 20th century. And what you also can do is to do a high intense activity, HIIT, high intense training. Because when you do that, your muscles will produce more carbon dioxide than your lungs are able to exhale. So that is a form of CO2 therapy. And usually the response from the muscles is that they grow stronger and bigger. And a major reason for that, which also a number of studies confirm, when the muscles rest in an environment that is rich in CO2, their response is to grow stronger and bigger. And another form of CO2 therapy would be to do KATSU, or blood flow restriction, BFR. Because if I work out this muscle and I restrict the blood flow, it's called KATSU or BFR, then I will prevent the carbon dioxide produced in this working muscle to leave the muscle. And again, the muscle will respond by growing bigger and stronger. You can also do ERB, exercise with restricted breathing. That could be nasal breathing, it could be breath holds, it could be training with a mask. And when you restrict the breathing, again, you will maintain more carbon dioxide in your body. So, as you can see, there are a number of different CO2 therapies, and many of them you can do completely on your own without the need for anything else except your own body and your breath. Are there any risks with CO2 therapy? Well, I would say it depends a little bit on who you ask. First, we should remember that when a person is doing a keyhole surgery in the stomach is inflated in order to give room for the surgical instruments and show the organs clearly so the surgeon can do his or her job. And the gas used to inflate the stomach is carbon dioxide. And that is because carbon dioxide is considered so safe. Because almost every single cell in our body produces carbon dioxide, which means that all the systems in our body know perfectly well how to get rid of excess carbon dioxide. So that's important to have with us. But we should, of course, pay attention to what potential risks there are. So when you do bag breathing, for example, if you hold the bag close to your face, it won't take long because the buildup of CO2 will be very high in the bag and the oxygen will go down. So if you continue with that, you will just faint, right? So the key is then in bag breathing to hold the bag a little bit away from your face. And another thing, if you're inhaling extra carbon dioxide with our CO2 inhaler, it is very important to pay attention to how your body reacts, how your mind, your emotions. We are really individual people, and the CO2 tolerance, they differ vastly from person to person. So the key is to pay attention to how your body reacts. And in general, CO2 is considered safe, but we should always be careful. So whenever you engage in CO2 therapy, whether that is out running with nasal breathing, or inhaling, or immerse your body in CO2, start low and slow and build from there.